according to the Washington Post. President Donald Trump called for the release of a classified memo, allegedly detailing abuses by the U.S. government. Top officials at the Department of Justice warned that releasing the classified document would be reckless if it did not first get an official review. John Kelly, Trump's chief of staff, reportedly noted Trump's desire to see the memo released to Attorney General Jeff Sessions, according to a senior administration official. However, Congress will make the final decision on whether the memo will be released. Many lawmakers have made it clear that what's in the memo is shocking.
The House Intel Committee set to debate and potentially vote later today on whether to release that controversial Obama-era memo to the public. We know that President Trump wants it out there, as do Republicans, but Democrats not so much. Let's bring in former Utah Congressman Jason Chaffetz. Thank you for joining us this morning.
Good morning.
Mr. Chaffetz, could you set up what's the case for releasing the memo?
Look, openness, transparency, we're different in the United States. We are self-critical. It's how you provide oversight of the executive branch. Even when it's critical, that's how you fix these problems. And if the executive branch, the deep state, knows that there's going to be this oversight, then maybe they'll act more appropriately knowing somebody's looking over their shoulder.
What's the case against releasing the memo?
Well, based on how adamant Adam Schiff is, I don't think he wants it out there because they think he is realizing it's very damning. It's very damaging to his narrative, which has never really been the case, that the collusion that was potentially happening was actually collusion within certain people. Again, not the rank and file members within the FBI, but I think what you're also going to see with this memo, again, I haven't read it, I haven't seen it, but I'm guessing that it's not just the FBI, that it's also the intelligence community and certain aspects or certain individual players within the IC. But that's who we are as a people. And so his argument will be, look, don't put that out there. Let's deal with this internally because it hurts his narrative.
So you append an op-ed on FoxNews.com this morning in which you say Chairman Nunes, House Intel Committee Chairman, has good options, but we should all strive to make sure they achieve truth, transparency, and ultimately justice. So based on what you know, without having actually read the memo, Congressman, would you say release the memo at this point if you were directly involved in that debate today?
I do. I think that's we err on the side of openness and transparency. A lot of this is going to focus back on the inspector general. Remember, a lot of these text messages and other information was released by the inspector general. Now, it was myself and I believe Elijah Cummings who also called for the inspector general to come in and look at many of these things. And as they started that process, they've uncovered a lot of things. They will come out with probably the most definitive report probably within the next 60 days, if not sooner. But the inspector general has been the one with his 450 employees, Michael Horowitz, been in there looking under the hood. But they've also had to pass along information as they found it relevant because these people are in senior most positions. And again, that's another reason to release the memo is these people have not evidently, as best I can tell, not lost security clearances, continued to be in very senior positions within very critical agencies within our government.
As you have been hearing Trey Gowdy, he has been adamant about this memo and the contents of it, and he is suggesting that the public would learn a whole lot about that anti-Trump dossier. Listen to this.
If you think your viewers want to know whether or not the dossier was used in court proceedings, whether or not it was vetted before it was used, whether or not it's ever been vetted, if you are interested in who paid for the dossier, if you're interested in Christopher Steele's relationship with Hillary Clinton and the Democrat National Committee, then yes, you'll want the memo to come out.
He's suggesting a whole lot there.
Yeah, it goes to the heart of what we're scared about in America is that our government is actually spying on us. And if they're using bogus information on funds that were obtained in a political campaign to write a dossier, I want to know the answer to that question. I would think the Democrats would want to know the answer to that question, too. I don't know why it's a partisan issue. It's going to be factually laid out. And I think this is a synopsis. It's just, according to those who've read it, it's just four pages on a wealth of information that was already generated within the government and given to the Intel Committee.
So we could learn a whole lot at 5 o'clock today when the House Intel Committee will sit down and debate whether or not to release the contents of this memo. How would this change the investigation? How, if we are to see the contents of that memo?
I don't know that they will necessarily, they may vote tonight. They'll probably have a vigorous debate behind closed doors. They won't necessarily release it today. I think right on the heels of the State of the Union, I think the intelligence community is going to want to have a bit of a say in that. But at some point, I do think a version of this will come out. It'll change the debate because we'll have more facts. And when instead of just the political rhetoric and political barbs on both sides of that, we'll actually have some factual basis to have further discussions. But again, I point back to Michael Horowitz, the inspector general, soup to nuts, been looking at this whole issue from the firing of James Comey and the meeting on the tarmac with Loretta Lynch, all the way, the whole gambit. And that hearing, when he's ready for that report, I think will be the most telling.
Your piece really lays out that Chairman Nunes has two solid options here. What are those?
Look, Chairman Nunes can do nothing. They can choose to hide it. They can release the memo. But I think what's also happening is they're sharing that information with their inspector general, and potentially, they're offering criminal referrals or referrals to the Department of Justice. And that's where the Attorney General Sessions probably already has this information and is going to have to figure out what to do with it. Now, he may have recused himself, and so this may go to Rod Rosenstein. But again, that's why I think the public needs to know who's making these types of decisions. But if people have actually broken the law, the Intel Committee will look at that, have their findings, and potentially make those referrals. When I was the chairman of oversight, very rarely, but we would make referrals to the Attorney General and hope that they would actually prosecute some cases.
Any forecasts as to how the outcome of this debate, what the outcome of this debate will be?
Look, I think we'll get more facts, and that it's been slow in coming, but I think it'll be methodical, and it'll actually be based on facts, not just political barbs. So this is who we are as a nation. We're different. We are self-critical. Mm-hmm. We are open. We are transparent. At least we're supposed to be.
Former Congressman Jason Chaffetz, good morning. Good to see you. Thanks for being here.
Why is it that leftist Democrats don't want the memo released? Do you think maybe they have something to hide? Voice your opinion in the comment section below.